नमस्कार दोस्तों, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट नो वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक दैट इज नो व्हाट आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ ग्लासवेयर्स आर देयर. ओके, सो वी कैन डिवाइड द ग्लासवेयर्स व्हिच आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द बार एंड नो फॉर रेस्टोरेंट इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, द ग्लासेस व्हिच हैव स्टेम एंड द ग्लासेस व्हिच डू नॉट हैव स्टेम. सो द फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द ग्लासेस व्हिच हैव स्टेम एंड आर ऑल्सो नोन एज स्टेमवेयर. ओके, so let's see what are the glasses that we have, and please watch this video till the end, then only your concept of glasswares will get clear. And while I am holding this glass in my hand, you can press the like button and subscribe also if you have already not subscribed the channel. So this glass which I have in my hand is a stemware, and you see that the stem is there in the glass for the purpose of holding it. Okay, so the guest can hold the wine with a stem. That is why stems are there. So all the glassware that you can see right now on the table that I have all have a stem, and the stems makes a role of to hold the wine glass with a stem. Now why we need to hold the glass with a stem? Now you see that every beverage which is served, whether it is wine or any other beverage, has a certain temperature at which it is served. Now if we talk about this red wine, red wines are served somewhere around 12 to 15 degrees Celsius. Okay, and if this wine will be served in a glass which do not have a stem, in that case the guest or the person will have to hold the glass like this. And now what will happen? The temperature of wine will get increased, okay, and that will destroy the taste of wine, and that is the reason stems are there in the glasses for wines. Okay, the second very important thing is that the beverages which have aroma, flavors, a lot of fragrances always have a narrower top. Okay, now what this top signifies, that all the aromas will be captured in this body. Okay, and when I'll put my mouth onto the glass, you will see my nose is also going inside. Okay, so at the time of tasting a wine, I can taste the wine as well, I can smell the wine. So this way the wines are served in these glasses. Okay, so this particular glass is a red wine glass. Now the red wine glass are also available in various sizes. You will see that the red wine glass, some red wine glass have body like this. Okay, so the purpose is that the younger the red wine, the body will be small, and the old the red wine is, their body will be little bigger in size. Okay, because old red wines have more of aromas, more of flavors than in comparison to the younger red wines. So that is why these wines are served in these glasses. The next glass that we have is a white wine glass, and you'll see that a stem is there, but the purpose of a stem is similar as with the red wine glass. The white wines are served somewhere around 9 degrees Celsius, so they are even served chiller than the red wines, and they are also to be holded with the stem. Okay, so this is how I hold the glass. Otherwise you can also hold with the stem. The next glass that we have is a brandy balloon, or we can also call it a sniffer glass. Why we are calling it a sniffer glass? Because it helps in sniffing. Okay, so that is the purpose. The body is very big, and the purpose is that the brandies which are cognac and armagnac, okay, they have lots of aromas and flavors, and that's why the body is very big, and when it is swirled, various aromas are to be generated, because oxygen will go inside, it will react with the brandy, and then the flavors will be developed. Okay, and the stem is small because this brandy is not to be consumed by holding the glass with the stem. It is it can be consumed like this. Okay, so the body temperature will increase the temperature of brandy, and that's how more flavors will be generated. That's why the glass has very small stem. Okay, then we have a margarita glass, and this margarita glass is known for the service of margarita cocktail. But apart from margarita, many other cocktails can also be served. You can see on the side what are the various other cocktails that can be served in a margarita glass. Next glass that we have for the service of cocktail is martini glass. And as I said, for margarita glass, this glass is also used for the service of martini cocktail. Otherwise, various many other cocktails can also be served in this glass. Okay, next we have a very elegant glass, and this is known as, you know, champagne flute. Okay, you can see the shape of glass. That stem is, you know, is good stem. That means we need to hold the glass with the stem, and because the champagnes are served chilled somewhere around 6 degrees Celsius, so we cannot hold a glass like this. Okay, so that is there. Next thing is that this glass is tapered from the base and then again getting tapered to the top. Okay, the purpose is that the champagne has carbon dioxide, and we need to trap the carbon dioxide in the glass for a longer time period. That's why this glass is getting tapered to the top. So that is the purpose of this glass. And I always believe that this champagne flute glass has some cut in the base, and that cut help in bubbling of carbon dioxide in the glass. What do you think about this? If you have any comment on this, whether you believe that there is a cut or there is no cut in the glass, please put your comments in the comment box and we can have a good discussion on that. Next we have a goblet glass, and this goblet glass can be used for various purposes. Maybe some cocktails can be served, mocktails can be served, and beverages like water can be served. Okay, so this is a general goblet glass, and many things can be served in this glass in a restaurant. Next glass for champagne, we have a champagne saucer, and this champagne saucer, the purpose is that now we want the guest to see the bubbly effect of carbon dioxide, and when champagne is served in this glass, you will see that bubbles are topping up on the glass. So that is the reason this glass is there for the service of champagne. Next glass that we have is a parfait glass, and this parfait glass can be used for the service of various shakes, cordials, and other drinks that are there in the bar. The only glass with the handle that we have is a Irish coffee glass. Okay, so what is served in this glass? As the name says, Irish coffee is served, and Irish coffee is a hot beverage. That's why this glass has a handle over here, so that the guest will not hold the glass like this. Otherwise, it will be held in this manner. So that is the purpose. The handle is there in an Irish coffee glass. Okay, so next glass that we have with a stem, very small stem, because in this glass beer will be served. Okay, and it is known as beer goblet glass. So this gives a nice eye appeal to the beer, and it is getting tapered to the top so that the carbon dioxide doesn't escape from the glass, and the beer looks pleasant in this glass. So that's why this glass is there for beer, and of course beer is served chilled so that we can hold the beer with the stem. Okay, so for elegant beer drinkers, this glass is there. Okay, now of course we should talk about these two equipment. This is known as Boston shaker, and the Boston shaker is a shaker which has two component. These two component are these two glasses. Okay, so they are to be combined, and various cocktails can be made in this shaker. Another shaker that is used for making cocktail is a cobbler shaker. So this one is a cobbler shaker, and unlike the Boston shaker, cobbler shaker has three parts. Okay, so one is the glass, second is the top, and then there is a lid over it. Okay, so these three components make a cobbler shaker. Now we will do the glasses which do not have a stem. The first glass that I have in my hand is a shot glass, and this shot glass is used for the service of various straight drinks, and this can also be used in the bar for measuring purposes. So various bartenders uses shot glasses for the purpose of measuring also. This particular shot glass is somewhere around 30 to 45 ml. Next glass that I have is a pony tumbler, Now, pony tumbler nowadays is used for the service of various juices in the bar. Otherwise, the purpose is no. This was invented during the horse races in Britain, where the people who are engaged in the horse races, okay, they used to have a shot of beer. So no, their butlers used to keep the glasses ready in the back, and the people who are into the horse racing, they used to go into the back and they used to drink a glass of beer, and that's how this glass was invented. Next we have this glass that is a juice glass, so regular juice glass which is used in the bar, somewhere around 5 ounces. Next we have a very important glass for any bar. It is a highball glass, and the purpose of this glass is to serve various cocktails, and it can be used for various reasons. So this is very important glass. The capacity is somewhere around 8 ounces. Next we have these two big glasses. One is the beer tank and one is the beer mug. Okay, so beer tank it is used for heavy drinkers, where whole bottle go into the glass, and this beer mug it's very handy in the glass, so various bar uses these glasses. Next we have a very classical glass, old fashioned glass, and there is a cocktail with the name old fashioned that is served in this glass. And apart from this, various other cocktails, you have a list over here, you can see how many cocktails are served in this glass. So very, very important glass for any bar to have. Another very important glass for the service of a cocktail is this glass. It is known as Tom Collins, and basically it is known as Collins glass, and Tom Collins is a cocktail that is served in this glass, okay. And it's very slim and tall, that's why it is also known as Slim Jim glass, and it is used for numerous cocktails in the bar. This glass is there for the service of beer. So we serve beer in this, and beer looked very elegant in this, and the froth is there on the top, and very tapered glass from the base and getting broader to the top. Next we have these decanters. So these decanters are used for the purpose of decanting red wines, okay. Now the older red wines which develop lees, okay, so we need to remove the lees before the service to the guest. So what we do, we hold this decanter like this, and then we hold the wine like this, and then we put a candle in between, okay. So we transfer the red wine slowly into the decanter, and once all the wine has been transferred to the decanter and lees are left behind, so then we serve the red wine from the decanter. Okay, so that is the purpose of these decanters. This one is small and this one is little bigger in size. So that's it in this session. In the next session we'll be talking about something very unique that I'm planning for. And please like the video, share the video, and subscribe the video. Thank you very much.